Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions zipForm Edition. Today, we'll be looking at creating an enforce template on a brokerage account. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's first understand the purpose of an enforce template. You have a set series of documents and tasks that must be completed for a transaction to be compliant. However, each of your agents has their own system of paperwork and is therefore not compliant. By using an enforce template, you can ensure that when your agents create transactions, they will automatically have the correct documents added and a task list already set up for them to complete. You will also be able to tell who is struggling and may require assistance. Let's start by creating the template. We're going to go to the Template tab in the software and click on New. The first step is to choose the transaction type. This will become very important when we get to the auto apply settings in the next step. For this scenario, we're going to create a template for a purchase. So we'll select New Purchase or Offer. The next step is to choose a name for this template. It helps if you give it a name in reference to the type of transaction it will be applied to. In this scenario, we'll call this the Residential Purchase Template. Next, we'll need to choose the transaction category. As you may have already figured out considering the name of the template, we're going to go with residential. Next, we'll need to decide how the template will apply to the transactions. We need to keep in mind we're creating an enforce template. The first option, do not automatically apply this template to new transactions, means exactly that. It won't apply automatically, but an agent can apply it manually if they want. Automatically apply this template to purchase residential new transactions means that the template will automatically apply to any new transactions that are of the purchase type and the residential category. You can see here as I change the category, so does the rule change to meet the new criteria. Finally, automatically apply this template to all new transactions means all new transactions will have the template applied. If your brokerage only deals with one type of transaction, this may be a good option for you. For our scenario, we're going to go with the second option in order to demonstrate how the system picks up that the type and category criteria are being met in order to apply the template. Now we'll need to actually turn on the enforced part of enforce template. Under compliance options, you'll see it reads, allow agents to edit and delete items applied from this template. By default, it will be switched to yes. If you switch it to no, you've just made it an enforce template. Agents will not be able to delete or edit items. This includes documents, placeholders, tasks, and more. They can still add more items to a document with the template applied, but they won't be able to delete or edit anything that was applied by the template. The last setting we'll select is the scope. This will determine who will have access to the template, or in this case with an enforce template, who this template will be applied to. Personal means the template will only apply to your account and no other users can access it. Global means anybody on the brokerage account can access it, or in this case, it will be applied to everyone on the brokerage account. Office means the template will be applied to only the specified office, which if you choose, an office drop-down option will appear. For this scenario, we're going to select Global. We finished choosing our settings for this enforce template. Let's click on Save to finish creating the template and move on to adding documents and tasks. Now that we've created our enforce template, let's begin filling it in. We'll start by adding some documents. To add documents, click on Add Doc. To add a form from a form library, simply click on Add Form. To add an external document from your computer, click on Browse for Document. You can also access other external drives by choosing from the options below. For this scenario, we'll be adding some forms from our form library. We've now added three forms to this enforce template. Agents will not be able to edit or remove these forms when applied to a transaction. It is important to note that they will still be able to add additional documents to the transaction. Placeholders can help keep track of required documentation in an enforce template. You can add a placeholder by clicking on Add Doc, then select Create Placeholder. You'll need to add in the name for the placeholder. If you've used a form from a form library, click on Use Standard Name and select the actual name from the form library to get the correct name of the form. Once you've chosen a placeholder, you can change the required setting from No to Yes. This is important for enforced templates, as there are settings we can set up for placeholders flagged as required. Click OK to finish making the placeholder. As a quick divergence, let's quickly show you why placeholders and required placeholders are important. Under the Admin tab in Broker Settings, there are a few options specific to placeholders. Under Notifications, you can set up to receive a notification every time a placeholder is filled, and when all required placeholders are filled in a transaction. Under Automation, you can activate a setting that will automatically mark a document for review after filling a placeholder. These settings aren't mandatory for an enforced template, but they could assist with speeding up the admin work. We've now created a required placeholder for each document. We can leave it like this, or we can organize it by adding some folders. You can create a folder by clicking on Add Folder, and then type in a name for the folder. You can then either click and drag the documents into the folder, or tick each document, click Move, then select the folder you want the documents to go into. For this scenario, we've made an extra folder called Completed Documents. All of our documents are now organized into folders, our original forms in Working Documents, and our placeholders in Completed Documents. This is just an example of how you could organize it. Folders are not required for enforced templates. Now that we have our documents sorted, let's create a checklist and fill it with tasks. We'll start by clicking on New Checklist. Here we can enter the name of the checklist. You'll see now that we've created the checklist that a category has been set up automatically. You can add more categories by clicking on New Category. You can add tasks to this category by clicking on Create a New Task, which we'll come back to. First, let's edit this category by hovering our mouse over the name until a pencil icon appears. Then click on it. You can enter a name for this category in the text entry box. Once you start entering text, color options will appear. You can select a color of your choice, then click Save. Now that we've finished creating our category, let's create a task. We'll start by clicking on Create a New Task. Before we continue, we need to remember that this will be part of an enforced template. This means that agents will not be able to edit any tasks you create. We'll start by giving this task a name. Now that we have a name, we need a due date. We can't set this to none because the agents won't be able to edit it once applied to a transaction. We can't use fixed either because the date is bound to change. Therefore, the only option for an enforced template is a relative due date. A relative due date is based on a certain number of days either before or after a specific event in the transaction, such as the listing date. When the template is applied to a transaction, the system will use the relative due date to generate a due date based on the data in the transaction. For example, if we set the relative due date to 5 days after the listing date, and the listing date in the transaction is July the 1st, then the system will generate a due date of July 6th. Here we have our completed task with a relative due date. This is an example of manually creating a task. Here is an example of what a checklist could look like with manually created tasks, with different colored categories, tasks, and relative due dates. There is another way to create tasks, however. You can also create tasks on documents themselves. Here are the placeholders we created earlier. You'll notice how below each one it says Set Due Date. If we click on it, we'll get a pop-up similar to creating a task, but with only a due date. As we mentioned before, our only option in an enforce template is a relative due date. So let's set one up and click Save. You'll see the placeholder now has a due date. If we click on Checklist, you'll see a new category, Documents, has been created automatically. Any other documents you add a due date to will automatically populate in this category. This can be a quick way to set up a checklist of tasks if you're looking for something more documentation related. That sums up this video on enforce templates for Transactions ZipForm Edition. For more detailed information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.